town Franklin has a vast, rich history, and they have several museums to document that. But there's a little known museum that you may not know the rich and important history behind. The McLemore House is a very vital part of the African American story here in Franklin. This house was built in the 1800s by a freed slave man named Harvey McLemore. And it's a story that Christy Farrow, who's with the Battle of Franklin Trust, she's a genealogist, and you're the tour guide here. So you talk about this wonderful home and the history behind it all the time.
I do. And it's not just Harvey McLemore's story, it's actually the story, that journey from slavery to freedom. And it is a personal passion of mine because I look at Harvey's generation of Americans. They experienced something that, as Americans, we will never experience again, ever in our history. They were slaves, and their parents were slaves, and their grandparents were slaves. They've never known freedom. They couldn't even envision it, and then all of a sudden, they're free, right? And they don't even own the clothes on their own back. And now, what do you do, right? What's in the future? So when I'm giving these tours, I love people to understand that this is such a unique experience. And Harvey wasn't educated. He wasn't a doctor or a lawyer or a teacher or a minister. And he was able to build his own house in the 1880s. And that's such an incredible feat, right? That's a success that we don't hear a lot when you're researching laborers, right? But Harvey, he was owned by a man named William McLemore, and William McLemore purchased a lot of the property in this area, and he sold land to Harvey and then allowed him to make payments, so it made it possible for Harvey to own a house.
Tell me about some of the other items in this room that when you come that you're going to learn here at the McLemore House.
This is a picture of the Forget-Me-Not Club. The Forget-Me-Not Club was basically women that got together, they met, and they taught each other how to beautify their homes. You don't think about that when you think about the end of slavery. They had a place that they could go sleep, but now they have homes. This is Harvey's granddaughter, and these are some of his other grandchildren. He only had one child, but she had quite a few children who, you know, had a lot of children. So he has a lot of descendants out there, but none of them have the last name McLemore, as far as I know, because his daughter married a Matthews.
The McLemore House Museum would not have been possible without the African American Historical Society of Williamson County, and Alma McLemore is the president of the organization, and you all have done an incredible job of bringing this house back to life.
Yes, the African American Heritage Society was founded back in 1992 by a group of concerned citizens who were interested in preserving and protecting African American history. We've got a group of people, we've got the community embracing us, and we've got a treasure in the McLemore House Museum. It is an awesome, awesome story, the story of an ex-slave who became a free man and built the house that was in the family for 117 years.
So you have an opportunity to come out, celebrate the McLemore House Museum at a special event coming up August 18th.
Saturday, August 18th, we're very excited about the first African American Heritage Society Black Expo. We've never done this before, but we're looking forward to it. There'll be tours of this building. We'll actually be across the street at Johnson Elementary, where we'll have vendors. We'll have some Titans cheerleaders. We'll have several celebrities. We're going to have a kids fashion show. You can go online at our website and get tickets, or you can come that day. There'll be food trucks for lunch that people can purchase, and it's just going to be a great day with just exposure and awareness to what we're doing here in Franklin, Williamson County.
So looking forward to that event. I will be there. I'm going to be there originally around 4, but I'll be there probably around 3 o'clock, just meeting and greeting and signing autographs.
Nice. Have you been there before?
I have not, so looking forward to that
as well.
I'm
looking forward to it, too. All right. Well-